Hello friends, now we are discussing about pro-eutectoid ferrite. From the picture, it is the eutectoid transformation picture and this is eutectoid point. Before achieving this eutectoid point, whatever the ferrite which is available at this, it is called as pro-eutectoid ferrite. Suppose at somewhere in between this point, if we take, suppose this is the percentage 0.2. At 0.2 percentage of carbon, because 0.008 is here, 0.8 would be here, and this is 0.025 percentage of carbon, and in between, suppose we take 0.2 percentage of carbon. Considering the steel at 0.2 percentage of carbon, the structural changes during the cooling for this steel would be at 0.1, so this is the 0.1. Alpha starts to be separate out at the grain boundaries of the gamma austenite. So alpha iron will starts to separate out at this point. And as the temperature decreases further, the amount of alpha is likely to be increased. If from one point it starts to, suppose this is the 2 point, up to 2 point, the increase in the percentage of alpha would be happen. The composition of alpha varies along the line CD. This is the line CD, and along this line it will be varying. Gamma along the line CE, it would be varying. The percentage of gamma would be varying along this side, and percentage of alpha ferrite would be varying along CD line. This continues up to 0.2%. So 2% when it is achieved. The amount of alpha and austenite at any temperature in between 1 and 2 would be found out by applying the lever rule. It is very simple. So lever arm can be prepared here and we can find out opposite arm divided by total length of arm. We will find out the amount of their occurrence. This alpha which has separated before the eutectoid transformation is called as primary or free or pro-eutectoid ferrite. So this is the concept of pro-eutectoid ferrite, which is likely to be separate out before this 0.2 percentage which we have mentioned and we have taken as example. Now let us discuss about the hypo-eutectoid steels. We have mentioned the definition of hypo-eutectoid steel as the steel which contains carbon lesser than the eutectoid point composition. Eutectoid point composition is 0.8 percentage of carbon. So hypo-eutectoid steel contains carbon from 0.008 to 0.8%. As the carbon increases, the amount of pro-eutectoid ferrite decreases and perlite increases. So here the figure which is representing the percentage of perlite and ferrite. So as the percentage of carbon increases, the percentage of perlite is likely to increase. Whereas ferritic, that is the pro-eutectoid composition, is likely to decrease. So 0.8%, it is totally perlitic composition which is available. So as 0.8 percentage of carbon, the amount of pro-eutectoid ferrite becomes 0% and perlite becomes 100%. This is been seen in this figure. So 0% of ferrite, that is pro-eutectoid ferrite, and 100% of perlite. Right. So as you go contrary, at 0.008 percentage, ferrite would be more, 100%, and perlite will be 0. So both ways you can prove this. For 0.008 percentage of carbon, the amount of alpha ferrite would be 100, and for 0.8%, the amount of perlite will be 100. So purest form of ferrite would be available at 0.008%, that is room temperature, and at 0.8% of composition, perlite would be available. ಮೈಕ್ರೋಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರಲ್ಲಿ ಹೌ ದಿ ಹೈಪೋಯೂಟಿಕ್ಟೈಡ್ ಸ್ಟೀಲ್ ಅಪಿಯರ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಫಿಗರ್ಸ್, ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಸ್ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಪಿಕ್ಚರ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಆರ್ ಅಟ್ ದ ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ ಆಫ್ 100x ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ರಿಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟಿಂಗ್ 0.1% ಆಫ್ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್, 0.2% ಆಫ್ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್, 0.4% ಆಫ್ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ 0.6% ಆಫ್ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್. ಸೊ ಲುಕಿಂಗ್ ಆಟ್ ದೀಸ್ ಫಿಗರ್ಸ್ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ಲಿ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ದಟ್ ಫೆರೈಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವೈಟ್ ಇನ್ ಕಲರ್. ಸೊ ಆಲ್ ದಿಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಅಪಿಯರಿಂಗ್ ಹಿಯರ್, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಫೆರೈಟ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ಲಿ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಮೇಕ್ ಅ ಕಾಮೆಂಟ್ ದಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಫೆರೈಟ್ ಪರ್ಸೆಂಟೇಜ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೋರ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಪರ್ಸೆಂಟೇಜ್ ಈಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಲೆಸ್, 0.1% ಆಫ್ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್, ಫೆರೈಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಮೋರ್. ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಗೋಸ್ ಫರ್ದರ್, 0.2% ಆಫ್ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್, ಸ್ಟಿಲ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಎ ಗ್ರೇಟರ್ ಪರ್ಸೆಂಟೇಜ್ ಆಫ್ ಫೆರೈಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸಮ್ ಡಾರ್ಕ್ ಸ್ಪಾಟ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಆರ್ ಅಪಿಯರಿಂಗ್, ದಿ ಗ್ರೇ ಸ್ಪಾಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಪಾರ್ಲೈಟ್. ಆ್ಯಸ್ ವಿ ಗೋ ಫರ್ದರ್ ಬಿಯಾಂಡ್ 0.4 ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಪರ್ಸೆಂಟೇಜ್, ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ದಿ ಕಾಂಪೋಸಿಷನ್ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಈಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ಲಿ ಟು ಅಪಿಯರ್. ಹಿಯರ್ ದ ವೈಟಿಶ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ಬ್ಲ್ಯಾಕಿಶ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್, ದ ಡಾರ್ಕ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಆರ್ ಈಕ್ವಲಿ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಟೆಡ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ 0.4% ಆಫ್ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಕಾಂಪೋಸಿಷನ್. ನೌ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ವಿ ಗೋ ಫರ್ದರ್, 0.6% ಆಫ್ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್, ಹಿಯರ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ಡಿಸ್ಟಿಂಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ದ ಡಾರ್ಕ್ ಸ್ಪಾಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಮೋರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಫೆರೈಟ್ ಕಂಟೆಂಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಲೆಸ್ಸರ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ದ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ವಾಸ್, ದ ಪ್ರೀವಿಯಸ್ಲಿ ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ದ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ವಿ ಹವ್ ಮೇಡ್, that as we go towards 0.8% ferrite will be decreasing and as we go towards 0.8 perlite will be increasing. So dark spots are more at 0.8% of carbon. This is the magnification at 100x. Now the next concept is about pro-eutectoid cementite. As we have seen pro-eutectoid ferrite before the eutectoid point, whatever the ferrite composition available, it's called as pro-eutectoid ferrite. Now pro-eutectoid cementite is what which is available here. So Fe3C, that is cementite which separates before the eutectoid transformation, would be available here. On the same lines as we have taken a section at this point, similarly the amount of austenite and amount of cementite can be calculated at these sections. Hypo-eutectoid steel we have seen. Now we will concentrate on the concept of hyper-eutectoid steel. Hyper-eutectoid steels are those steels which contains free cementite from 0 for 0.8% of carbon and increases very linearly with increasing carbon and reaching maximum for 2% of carbon. So this is the representation of hyper-eutectoid steel. And at 1.2% of carbon, the same magnification which we have seen previously at 100x, we can see that how this hardness is mentioned. So very lesser points of whitish part, that is the part of alpha ferrite, and the dark and blackish or grayish part is of perlite. So cementite appears white and perlite appears dark. This perlitic composition, as we have seen in the previous figure, it is a lamellar structure. So alternate lamellars of cementite and alpha ferrite are arranged one by one and the composition is changing like this. This is the hyper-eutectoid steel composition. Depending on these hypo-eutectoid steel we have seen, which are having lesser than 0.8%, which are having 0.8% and above are called as hyper-eutectoid steels. Now classification and applications of steels. Criteria for classifications are many more. There are approximately 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 criteria for the classifications. Criteria for classifications are 7. Number 1, amount of carbon. depending on the percentage of carbon present within the steel, the steels are categorized. Second one, depending on the amount of alloying elements and the carbon percentage. So here is the alloying content, which makes it the second point of distinction, that is the classification criteria. The percentage of manganese, chromium, phosphorus, sulfur, and many more alloying elements, which are likely to describe the type of steel. It is the second criteria, amount of alloying elements and carbon. The third one is amount of deoxidation. Maybe it is a killed steel, semi-killed steel, or these are the amount of deoxidations which decides what type of steel which is likely to manufacture after the processing. Fourth point of criteria for the classification would be grain coarsening characteristics. Whether the grain coarsening characteristics as per the ASTM numbers, how the structures are arranged and what are their grain structures, they are the fourth point of distinction, grain coarsening characteristics. Fifth point is method of manufacture. Fifth point would be how the steel is manufactured, what type of manufacturing process it has adopted for its manufacturing. That would be the fifth point of classification. Depending on the method of manufacture, steels can be categorized. Sixth point of distinction would be method of hardening. What type of hardening, whether it is shallow hardened or whether it is full hardened, that types are been mentioned here in the method of hardening. Last point would be the form and use. What a typical application that the steel finds, depending on the application, the distinction or the classification could be possible. So seventh point would be the form and use. So these are the 7 points of classifications: amount of carbon, amount of alloying element and carbon, amount of deoxidation, grain coarsening characteristics, method of manufacture, method of hardening, form and use. One by one, let us elaborate. The first and foremost is the amount of carbon. The amount of carbon which is present in the steel will divide the steels into these criteria. Plain carbon steel can be categorized into further 3 subtypes as low carbon steel, medium carbon steel, and high carbon steels. Type of steel, if suppose low carbon steel, what is the weight percentage of carbon? 0.008% to 0.3%. This is low carbon steel. Medium carbon steel, 0.3% to 0.6%. High carbon steel, 0.6 to 2%. If we want to show it and represent it on a line diagram, on a line scale, so we have mentioned 0.008% of carbon here, up to 2% of carbon percentage on the line and scale of 0.2. So 0.2, 0.4, 0.6, 0.8, 1, 1.2, 1.4, 1.6, 1.8 and 2. From 0.008 to 2% and above that, up to 0.3%, we will call it as a low carbon steel. From 0.3 to 0.6, it is medium carbon steel. From 0.6 and onwards up to 2%, it is high carbon steel. So increase in the percentage of carbon above 0.6 will make a category high carbon steel. One more distinction that we have seen and described it previously, that eutectoid point would be 0.8. So it is called as eutectoid steel. The steel which is having a fixed composition of carbon 0.8%, it is called as eutectoid steel. The steel which is having lesser percentage than 0.8 would be depicted as hypoeutectoid steel, and the steel which is having high percentage than 0.8 would be called as hypereutectoid steel. So these are two distinct points which we want to make it. Applications of low carbon steel. As we have mentioned that low carbon steel is having 0.008% to 0.3% of carbon. Naturally, it would be the purest form of iron which is available. Alpha ferrite would be the prominent phase which would be present in the low carbon steel. Therefore, whatever the characteristics that we have seen for alpha ferrite, similarly we can mention it for the low carbon steel. The properties are low carbon steel are soft, ductile, malleable, tough, machinable and weldable. They are soft, ductile, malleable, tough, machinable and weldable. Cannot be hardened by heat treatments, as they are having very purest form of iron and low percentage of carbon. So it is rarely went for the heat treatments. Rarely it undergoes the heat treatments. They are good for the cold working processes. Maybe you can take the rolling sheets, HRC sheets, the press working, the tinning, the galvanizing sheets. All these cold working processes would be preferred for low carbon steels. Good for the fabrication work. So for fabrication work, this preferred as a workable steel. So wires, as it is a ductile, can be drawn into wires. So ductility proves that low carbon steels can be drawn into wires. It can be formed into nails. Then the screws can be manufactured out of the low carbon steels, rivets, low carbon and zinc plated. Mild steel welding rods are also been manufactured with the low carbon steel. So these are the typical applications and the pictorial representations of all these low carbon steel applications. Similarly, we can add on these sheets. So cold working is one of the distinctive characteristics of low carbon steel, and can be seen here the application of HRC sheets, 10 mm thickness low carbon steel sheets, and for the boiler and ships, whatever the walls which are being manufactured is also been shown here. Some carbon steels can be applied for manufacture of gears, camshafts and connecting rods. Very rarely for the connecting rod, but we can mention that connecting rods are also being made by low carbon steel. The railway axles, the axles of railway are joined by the fish plates. So the fish plate is having the content of low carbon steels. Crossheads are also been manufactured with the low carbon steels. In addition to these, tubes of bicycles, automobiles and small forgings are made out of low carbon steel. Now the next category of medium carbon steel, it is also known as machinery steels. Percentage, as we have mentioned, 0.3% to 0.6% of carbon would be the percentage of carbon which makes it medium carbon steel. These steels have intermediate properties to those of low carbon steel and high carbon steel. So it is a moderate property steel structure. They are medium hard, not so ductile, not malleable, medium tough, slightly difficult to machine, weld and harden. They require high cooling rates for hardening, and hardness produced after the hardening is not so high. So most of the times it goes for hardening process, but the hardening application would be not so high. Means if you consider hyper-eutectoid steel and medium carbon steel, there is no comparison. Hardening would be more at the hyper-eutectoid steel as compared to the medium carbon steel. The depth of hardening is also very shallow. It is very less, and hence they are shallow hardening type of steels. They are difficult to cold work, and most of the times they need to be hot worked. So most of the times medium carbon steel or machinery steel is preferred to be hot worked. Some of the applications like bolts, the lock washers, hammers, large forging dies, springs, turbine rotors, crank pins, cylinder liners, railway rails, railway tires, they are made up of medium carbon steel. The next category of carbon steel would be high carbon steel. The percentage is very clear now. Whatever the percentage which exceeds 0.6% of carbon would be come to this category of high carbon steel. All hyper-eutectoid steels you can categorize to high carbon steel. They are also called as tool steels. The alternate name for high carbon steel would be tool steels. The name itself signifies that it is used to manufacture the tools out of this high carbon steel. They are hard, wear resistant, brittle, difficult to machine, difficult to weld, and can be hardened by heat treatment. The hardness produced after hardening is very high. It is incomparable with the previous two types, low and medium carbon steel. Low, very minimal, to medium to some extent, but high carbon steel undergoes a very high hardening process, and that's why the depth of hardening is very high. That is, hardenability, the ability of a material to get hardened, is more as compared to medium carbon steel. So it is not shallow hardened, it is high hardened type of steels. These steels cannot be cold worked and hence are hot worked. Always they are hot worked. Some of the tools which are manufactured with the help of high carbon steel are being shown picturally here. High carbon steel machine screw, hexagonal dies. These are the dies or the pipe vices, like these are some of the punches which are manufactured with the high carbon steel. Clips are again manufactured with high carbon steel. In addition to these applications, car bumpers, clutch discs, vice jaws, then comes shear blades, drills, leaf springs, music wires, knives, razor blades, balls and races for ball bearings, mandrels, cutters, files, wire drawing dies, reamers and metal cutting saws. So most you can categorize the tools. So tools are manufactured by high carbon steel.